So, many people have a real challenge with having this conversation in a space of both and versus either or. I.e., we have to hold police accountable. We have to hold our elected officials accountable. And also, there is space in which, as citizens, we can understand some of the challenges that the people on the street are facing when they're enforcing the law and not, I don't know, maybe exacerbate the problem in a greater way. I think that, for instance, if I were in a situation where the police came to approach me, they may shoot and kill me anyway, right? Just because, no matter what I do. But if I behave in a certain way, it may make that possibility more likely. Is that correct? And can we say both and or what? I mean, or are we throwing this completely on the issue of the
It
police?
is an
I
unfortunate
mean, it is unfortunate,
and.
and I
It
don't.
is an
Yeah.
unfortunate
I'm
and.
just being real.
But Ted, you have the social, economic, educational advantages
Sure.
that many other African
That's true.
American men in particular
That's true.
don't have.
That's true.
That, where you may react a particular way, they may not. And
That's
who
true.
knows, the shoes they've walked in that day
That's
and
true.
what they have experienced that day, that something sets off a trigger.
I think you're very right.
Right?
I
And
think,
the fact that they have to worry about that.
you know what? Listen, I don't disagree with you. And this is where I love having this conversation because so many of our political conversations are, either this or you're that. And I can learn from what you're saying and what you're saying as well. I agree with you. I just want to, in my life, in my work, I'd like to help build a culture of these young men understanding potentially that you are a target and that people may have it out for you, so let us not make their job easy.
Oh, okay. So, oh, I feel
And
so country because I want to be
and we
like
need to
my
hold the
daddy
police
said.
accountable too,
You
and
do need to hold accountable, but here's the thing. This is what I tell my sons. If you know there are sharks in the water, then why go to the beach in bloody shorts? Come on. Come on. There's
Okay.
just a level of responsibility. There just is. And it's not to scapegoat either. It's an and conversation. Now we're talking about these personal responsibilities. And you're right. I understand what you're saying. Officer John comes across, Ted's had a bad day, and now he's ready to snap off, and now he's at the crescendo. He's all, don't push me because I'm close to
Yeah.
the edge zone. But the officer should be able to be trained in such a way to
You're
say,
exactly
okay, I've got
right.
a mental
That's
health
true.
You're exactly
issue.
right.
Let
That's
me
true.
show how,
Yeah.
let me de-escalate this. So that's where the
That's
and, that's
exactly.
where the and comes into.
I mean, I've always thought that why do we have to resort to lethal force?
Right.
Aren't there non-lethal ways of dealing with challenging problems? And I think it comes
And
down to
why do we
that.
have to shoot someone 16 times when they're
16
down on the
times.
ground?
Do you all know that
Absolutely.
as much as we talk about the 16 shots of Laquan Ford, that's not the most shots given
No.
by a police officer?
Oh my
It's actually
wow.
17 shots in the 21st Ward.
That's a
Alderman Wilkins.
great way to end this, unfortunately. A
Yeah.
tragic way, but thank you for sharing that information. And thank you guys for joining us today.
Thanks, Tom. Thanks,
Absolutely.
Sam.
Thank you for watching, and please join us to watch the full episode of this important conversation on police brutality.